Fertile. If you don't know me, I'm Glam by Gemma. Today I filmed a Valentine's Day look using the Modern Renaissance palette, of course. What else would I use for this kind of look? Come on. So very simple, very easy. If you guys want to see how to get this look, please just keep watching.
Hi guys. So I'm starting off with priming my eyes with the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion in the shade Original. Then going in with the shade Tempera from the Modern Renaissance palette, I'm going to set that primer that I just put down using a big fluffy brush. Then I'm going with my transition shade. I forgot to film a shot of this, but it's called Bon Fresco. Then using Love Letter, I am putting that over the transition shade to build up the kind of pinks and reds that I want to get in this look. It's really important to build colors so that we don't go in with any harsh lines or harsh, bright colors that we won't be able to blend out. Then I'm going in with Cypress Umber. This is a dark brown shade to add definition to the crease, using a smaller pointed crease brush to do this. I like to create a small V in the outer corner to create a cat eye effect. This really helps make the eye look larger. Now I'm blending all the colors together using a big fluffy brush from Morphe. And I'm picking up some more pink to increase the pigment. Now I'm just going in with the light shade on my lid. This is really going to make the eye pop. And now using my Kat Von D tattoo liner in Trooper, I'm just going to line my eyes. This is my absolute favorite liner in the world. I'm not doing a wing, just a very simple line over my lash line. Now for my face, I'm going to use my Urban Decay D-Slick Primer. This primer, you know for me, is absolutely amazing. And then I'm going to go in with my Urban Decay All Nighter Foundation. I'm in the shade 2.5. I'm just going to dot that all over my face. I did not realize that both these products were Urban Decay. That was totally not planned. Now I'm just going to pat that in with my Beauty Blender. I have found that using a Beauty Blender is the most effective way for me to blend out foundation. I've tried to use brushes and they're not bad, but I just always end up going back to my Beauty Blender. I feel like it gives the most flawless, natural finish. Brushes tend to look streaky sometimes and I'm just not about that. Beauty Blender works for me like 100% of the time, so I am a believer. Now I'm just going to finish dotting that all over my face. Fun fact, I filmed the eye look for this video separately from the face look, and the eye look actually didn't film. So if you see any like discrepancies between the way the eyeshadow looks in the first part of the video versus the second part, that's because they were kind of filmed in two different days. So that is my bad. Yeah, I really liked the look, so I wanted to get it out even if it wasn't like perfect. Now I'm taking my Laura Mercier powder and dusting that all over my face in order to set the foundation. This brush is seriously the most amazing thing to set my face. I got it. It's part of a cosmetics line with Ulta. It's just like, it's the perfect size, texture. I am obsessed with it. Now I'm going in with Tarte Shape Tape in the shade Fair Neutral and putting that under my eyes and blending it out. Okay, yes, I use a lot of concealer. I know. I'm okay with it. Once again, I'm going in with my damp Beauty Blender just to blend that out. And now I'm putting concealer on my forehead, the bridge of my nose, and my Cupid's bow, my chin, just to even out. I also use concealer to highlight, not just to hide any imperfections. That's why it's a little bit lighter than the rest of my skin. So that's why I kind of put it everywhere in order to even out the highlighting that I've been doing. I'm just going to keep blending that out with the Beauty Blender, and now I'm going to go in with my Laura Mercier, again, translucent setting powder to set all the places where I put the concealer so that it doesn't crease. If I don't do this, my concealer will crease. It's just me. It has nothing to do with the quality of the concealer. It's just, it will always happen to me, so setting my concealer is pretty necessary. I also set my smile lines because that's kind of the first place where I get creasing. I find that this helps a lot. Lastly, I bake on my chin because this is where I get like the first place that I get oily throughout the day. So if I bake, it kind of prevents that from happening. Next, I'm going in with my beat up as shit contour palette. Seriously, I know I need to get a new one, but I didn't realize how bad it was until I held it in front of the camera and was slightly embarrassed that that's what it looks like. I've had this thing forever. Anyway, so I'm going in with the lightest and the medium shade in order to contour, going in my cheekbones and then on the outer edges of my forehead. Now I'm going in with my Marc Jacobs Omega Bronzer in the shade Tantric. This is a smaller size, obviously, but seriously, I've had this size, this product forever. If you can get your hands on the small one, I feel like it'll last you forever. I am obsessed with this shade for when I want like a warmer look. Now I'm carving out my contour using the same Laura Mercier powder just to make everything a little bit sharper. I don't like when things are muddy or when they go a little bit too far down my cheek, so I tend to do this regularly. Now I'm going in with a Laura Geller cream highlight that I totally didn't show on camera. I use this to kind of set my highlight before going into the powder. And for powder highlight, I'm going in with one of my favorites, Becca and Jaclyn Hill collaboration in Champagne Pop from the limited edition face palette. This is one of my absolute favorite highlights. It's so blinding, and right now I'm just dusting this on top of my cheekbones. Next, I'm going to wipe away the baking that I was doing, mainly under my contour and on my chin. For blush, I'm going back into that palette. I'm using the color Spirits Rose. It's a really gorgeous, luminous, light pink, and I am just putting that on the apples of my cheeks, and then I'm bringing the blush upwards towards my cheekbones. I really feel like this makes a difference instead of just piling onto one place. Next, I'm curling my eyelashes. This is pretty necessary for me. I have like short little eyelashes. I don't know what I was laughing at. And now I'm going into mascara using the Benefit Roller Lash. I happen to love this mascara. It is one of my absolute favorites. Next, I'm going to be doing the lower lash line. This is kind of just to finish up the look. I really feel like it ties it all together. I'm going in with that pink shade Love Letter and sweeping that on my lower lash line, kind of putting it everywhere. And then I'll be going in with that darker shade Cypress Umber and keeping that on the outer corner, just like I did on the top part of my eye. Last, I'm going in with that light shade, and I'm going to put that in my inner corner, just like I did on the top part of my eye, and then I'm going to highlight my inner corners. For lips, I'm using an ultra matte lip from ColourPop called Clueless. ColourPop has some of my absolute favorite lipsticks, and I just wanted something like a pink, but that had some purple undertones in it to go with the eye, something like a dusty rose type thing, and I felt like this color was absolutely perfect for the look. Lastly, I'm going to spray myself with the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray.
So this is the finished look. I hope you guys like it. Please hit the like button below and subscribe to my channel if you do. I hope you guys have a great Valentine's Day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.